Well, there were three things. Firstly, I had to love the song. Secondly, I had to sing it a lot. And the third thing, I had to learn something from these songs. When I first time I heard the song Africa, for example, I thought the words were fantastic. It created a great picture in my head. The singer, the notes that he sings, you know, oh, bless the rains down in Africa. I mean, this is so from the heart. I love that song. So for me, it was those three things. Each song had to work with each one. I didn't feel intimidated at all in the recording studio. Because I loved the song so much, I felt that I could give them something valuable. I could make the original composers and singers proud of what I did. That's what I wanted to do.
Karina, Karina.
Well, we're in the fishing village of Dorky, which is a few miles south of the city centre of Dublin. And I lived here with my family for 16 years, just a little house just up there. I would come down here in all weathers, not just in a sunny day like this, but when the rain is falling and the wind is howling, it's actually very inspirational.
There must be some way out of here. Said the Joker to the...
I've chosen this next song out of so many Bob Dylan songs that I love. It's called All Along the Watchtower. And in this song, people have no idea what's going on, but something's going on. And the second thing I love about this song is it's like a film. It starts in the prison cell with the Joker and the thief, and then slowly the camera comes back, and there's a fort in the desert like that. And at the very end, the sun is going down. In the distance, you see a cloud of dust, and two riders are coming. And you say, what is this? So All Along the Watchtower.
All along the watchtower, princess kept the view, while all the women came and went, barefoot servants too. Outside in the distance.
Bob Dylan has always been a huge hero of mine. And one night I was returning from a recording session in London to my hotel, and a man walked across the lobby and said, I know who you are, you're Christopher Burgh. And I said, excuse me, who are you? He said, my name is Roger McGuinn. I went, no, the man from the Birds. And he said, I know somebody who'd like to meet you. I said, who's that? He said, Bob Dylan. I said, oh, you're pulling my leg, as we say in English. And he said, no, we've been doing a concert with Bob Dylan. And he took me into the bar and he tapped this man on the shoulder and says, hey, Bob. And he goes, what? It's Christopher Burgh. And Dylan turns around and I'm going, oh, my God, it's Bob Dylan. He says, I know you. He says, I've got your record in my car back in America. I said, you're a joke. He said, no, I love the way you sing and the way you write songs. And I spent the next 2 hours floating because I'd met my hero. We'd drinking together and chatting. And to this day, it was the most amazing feeling.
No, I can't forget this evening. Oh, your face as you were leaving.
For me, one of the greatest love songs ever written and recorded is Without You, recorded by Harry Nilsson. I was singing it once in a soundcheck in Kensington Palace Gardens prior to a big open-air show, and a young woman who had been listening to the soundcheck came up to me and she said, I know that you love that song because I've heard you sing it before, but I was the girl the song was written about. Said, yep, I lived with one of the two members of Badfinger who wrote the song, and we had a quarrel, and I went out, and when I got back, he said, I've written this song. And she said, I know you love this so much, and you respect the song so much, that I'll get you something special. So next time I saw her, she gave me this, which is a copy of the original handwritten lyric to Without You. When I was a teenager, of course, like all other teenagers, you fall madly in love and your heart is breaking when you have to part. And this song always was important to me because at the time I was about 15 or 16 and madly in love with a girl called, I think her name was Juliet. And this song was on the radio and I thought it was perfect for she and I. And since then, it's always become a favorite, not just because of that situation, but because it's a beautiful song, and it reminds me of those years, and indeed every summer, where you have to say goodbye to somebody. It's called Sealed with a Kiss. So we gotta say goodbye for the summer. But darling, I promise you this, I'll send you all my love every day in a letter sealed with a kiss. Well, we're in a small room above the Samuel Beckett Theatre in Trinity College, formerly known as the Players Theatre, where I used to act a little bit and sing in reviews. And this piano is the same piano that was there all those years ago. Let's see what it sounds like. And here's a song I used to sing regularly on this piano. Ooh, doesn't sound so good.
The long and winding road.
No, I think this is going to be a long and winding road to find another piano, not this one.
The long and winding road.
Many of my friends in the music business regard the orchestration and the arrangement of the songs The Long and Winding Road and Across the Universe as some of the greatest ever written in pop music. I invited Richard Hewson to once come and conduct with a full orchestra and choir a few shows that I was doing in front of beautiful places like Blenheim Palace and Hampton Court Palace in the UK. And the first night when we started The Long and Winding Road, I had tears in my eyes, I was getting the chills, because this is the guy that wrote the piece of music that went with this fantastic song.
You left me standing here.
Each song, you see, has a story behind it, why I decided to record that particular song. Each one has a memory for me, and that's why I call the album Footsteps. Just to tell people why these are steps along the route of my musical journey. My plans for the next few months are obviously to support and promote this new album, Footsteps. I'm looking forward to doing concerts with the new songs. I've just done recently a tour with a full orchestra, plus a band, of course. I've got a very good band. So yeah, I'm going to be busy not only in Europe, but hopefully in Iran and back to Russia and the Middle East and North America. So it's going to be a busy year. What I wanted to do was help people understand why I've chosen these songs. It takes me back from the beginning, when it's just me and a guitar, to ending the way I play now with a full band and thousands of people in concerts. Again, a place that I never even dreamed of, because my dreams began right here at Burgh Castle.